Hello folks, this is Shardul Gavande from Ace Knowledge, and in this video we are going to create guessing game application in Scratch. So how does this game work? So we have a cat over here, and this cat will take any two random numbers between 1 and 10, and it will ask us to give the correct answer of multiplication of these two random numbers. So let us start our project. Firstly, we'll change our backdrop as this white looks very much simple. So let's choose a backdrop from here. We'll take this concert backdrop. Now this looks very attractive. And since this cat takes two different numbers, which means we have to create two different variables. Let's go to the variable part, click on my make a variable, and we'll give the variable name as number one for this sprite. And again, we'll create a new variable as number two for this sprite. Okay, so we have these variables. You can see it over here on the stage. So let us place them over here, number one and number two. Now we'll initialize those variables to zero. Firstly, let us place our flag. When flag is clicked, then go to variable, set our variables to zero. Set first is number one to zero, and second number two to zero. Fine. Now we have to take random numbers from 1 to 10 and store those numbers in number 1 and number 2. So we need a loop which will run continuously and take the random numbers. So we will place from control forever loop, and under this we will have our set variable, our set number 1. We have to pick any random numbers. So for that functionality, we'll go to our operator code section, and from here we have this pick random number 1 to 10. So remove this 0 and place this block over here. The same thing for number 2, set over here number 2, and again from the operator pick random number from between 1 to 10. So we'll put a wait also of 1 second before the loop starts. Fine. Now we have successfully generating random numbers and storing it in the variables. Now we need to make this cat ask the end user to, as in what would be the answer for these two questions or these two numbers, number one into number two. So where will we take the ask part? From the end user in the sensing part, sensing code block. So over here you have this ask what's your name and wait. This block you can drag and drop it over here. Now this question which the computer or the cat is asking, I need to store it somewhere, right? I might create another variable and store the answer over there, or I will directly make a tick mark on this built-in answer over here. Fine. So on the stage you can see the answer part is been reflected. Okay, so the question I want to ask is, it is not what's your name. Okay, so I want to ask is, what is number one into number two? So there is a big line of statement and I cannot put it in one single ask block. So what I'll use it from the operator, I will use the join operator. Okay, so join, it will simply link or bind two values. So I'll remove from here apple as well as banana, and here I will enter my own question, which is what. First is what, then next again I will take join operator. From here I'll place it on the second part of first join operator. Over here I will write as what is, again this banana will go off. Then again join, and over here now in place of this I will put my variable which is number one will go over here, and again one more join operator, place it over here. This I will have times or simply your multiplication part, and here I will put in the last part my variable 2, which is num2. Okay, so you can put a space over here so that it does not stick to each other. So now we need to check the answer entered by the user, whether is it correct with the multiplication part of number 1 and number 2. So for that reason, we'll take a condition as if then else. Till now we were just seeing if then condition. Now we have come across if then else condition. So if the answer is correct, then what it should print, else what it should print. So if we have a condition over here, and we'll check it by using equal to operator, we'll place it over here. So if answer equal to number 1 into number 2. So again, go to the operator, since we have to tell the computer that this is the calculation part which we have to perform and check with the user's answer. So this is the multiplication operator. So we'll put the variables first, number 1 over here in this box and number 2 over here, and entirely drag and drop it and place it over here. So if answer equal to number 1 into number 2, then the cat will say something. So it will, what it will say, correct for 2 seconds, else it will say incorrect. Okay, and we'll check by running the code. What is 8 times 1? So 8 times 1 is what? 8 itself. If I enter, it is saying correct. That's good. Again, it is asking question, what is 6 times 60? Now if I enter the answer wrong, and if I hit enter, it says incorrect. So it is taking any random value from between 1 to 10. Yes. So this will go on. So what we can add more to it is, we can give chances to the user that if you give correct answer, it is fine, good. But what if you give incorrect answers? There should be a limitation, right? In every game, we have chances. So we'll give the user 3 chances. So in between these 3 chances, if he goes anywhere wrong, the game will directly stop. Okay. So let's take another variable. So we need to initialize a variable. We'll take a variable first. Let's make a variable as chances for this sprite, and I will initialize first chances variable to 0. So set chances to 0 at the very start. So I have set my chances variable value to 0, so there would be only 3 chances for the user to give his correct answer. So the moment he gives any incorrect answer, the value of chances will go on increasing. Okay. So once it reaches to 3, the game will stop. That means he has only 3 chances to give the correct answer. So we need to make some changes or set the value of chances and increment it only when the user gives incorrect answer. So we'll set our chances variable value and increment it by 1. Okay. So we'll place this plus operator, and I will pass here chances plus. Okay, so suggestion is that you take this first outside, place your required variables in it, number in it, and then take the entire thing over here. So if the answer is incorrect, the value of chances will go on incrementing by 1. Now what I want to check, that if it reaches to 3, if the value of chances reaches to 3, then simply stop the game. So I will have a if condition over here, if then, and place it over here. So if the chances, we'll take operator again, and we have to check whether equal to 3. So if chances equal to 3, then what should happen? So we'll simply go into the control and stop all. So if the value of chances is equal to 3, then the game will stop and the cat will say something to us. So say over here, okay, let us put this first and then it will stop the game. So it will say us guess limit completed. Okay, and will play the game now. See, chances initially is 2, 0. 10 times 8, I'll enter the wrong answer. So chances will increment to 1. Then again, second time, I'll enter the wrong answer, incorrect. The value of chances will increment to 2. And this is my last attempt. And if I give again the wrong answer, it should show guess limit completed. Incorrect answer. And yes, it is showing guess limit completed. Okay. So you can add it more to it by adding the scores. You can take a variable as scores. And when the user gives the correct answer, you can increment his scores. Okay. So that's it from this video. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like the video, share with your friends as much as possible, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.